People, the Musk is here. Do you see this mess? In the previous episode of Terraria 1.3.0.3, a blood moon appeared and I had to end things so that you can have a chance of watching this thing in its whole splendor. So, what's happening here? For the people that don't know what the heck blood moon is, it's some sort of Terraria event, probably based on the actual blood moon event where the moon looks in a red fashion because, I don't know, Mars or something. The thing is, here, zombies can open doors and my villagers are in danger. I could just go away and try to fight them in a place where villagers are not nowhere to be found. But there's no fun in that, right? No, you have to... how do you call it? Make it interesting. Try to save them. It's some like when, you know, if you watch things like, I don't know, The Walking Dead. This is the equivalent of letting the zombies enter the town and then everything goes down, the poop hits the fan, and everyone is attacking and everyone is screaming, and then there's like 10 episodes of soap opera, and when everything gets settled up, there's like 10 traveling episodes, and afterwards, they settle up again on another town and everything stacks over. I didn't watch the series myself, I read the comics up to a point, and well, they were on a little town, then they were not, then they were on a jail, and then they were not, then they were on a town, and then they were not, and then they were on a bigger town, and that's probably where it no longer exists. You know how this goes, not trying to diss it or anything, I'm just saying that, well, it's some sort of loop that's expected from a place where zombies are always rampant, and when even one zombie inside of the town means that everyone can die. So, well, that's more or less what's happening here. If I let one zombie inside, well, and I can easily cheese my way out of this by just putting a wooden wall or something and preventing them from entering, but that's not fun. You know that I like taking risks here and there, and that's why I keep making episodes where I just have to retrieve my inventory, but okay. It happens, it's fun, for me at least. But that's how this episode is going to go, at least until the blood moon is over. Because, to be honest, there's not much else to do. I found some ice cavern over there, but the best thing about this is that ice are spawning at a higher rate, which means that I'll have more materials to actually go and fight the boss again. The one that ran away. I killed a zombie. A demonite, the 15 of them. And see, another lens, how many of these do I have already? 5! See, this was already a productive blood moon. Besides, I think I killed a big important zombie, the bride, because, well, there's a bride and there's also a groom. You get an achievement that you kill one of them, the groom, I think. And now I can equip this wedding dress. There we go, don't I look pretty? Yeah, probably. Let's equip it, the whole thing. There we go. You can't even look at them, but I apparently still have my ninja... my ninja pants? Yeah, ninja pants. Because ninjas need a special kind of pants. I don't know. I'm just thinking about ninjas. The first thing that comes to my head is Naruto and his his bright orange tabi? Do you call it tabi? I don't know. But yeah, I don't know. I only like, I'm more of a One Piece person, but friends keep telling me, hey, you should read Naruto or something. How do you expect us to read One Piece and there over 700 chapters if you don't want to read a 600 chapter something Naruto thing? So I started reading it, read one volume, and it looks so far so somewhat good. I think I could get hooked into it if I end more time over there. But still, I'm not trying to advertise anime, manga, whatever, One Piece for us as much as I like it. But, well, it's more of a thing that if I'm going to advertise something, I might as well advertise my channel. So if you're watching this, for some reason haven't decided to start watching from this episode instead of watching the first one, then, well, just, I don't know, leave a comment, subscribe, I don't know, follow me on Twitter at memoski1, and something, I don't know. Well, that's the advertising of the day. I hope you liked it, and I should probably stop. But really, I'm... really hope that my... oh, Gilbert died. I think he was the demolition. No, he's... oh, it was the mercant. Well, he shall be remembered, I suppose. Poor Gilbert. Anyhow, What I was saying is that on my Twitter is, well, on the bottom left of the screen, if everything is going alright, because I really hope that I'm recording this time. So, the thing is, it's Memoski 1, because apparently Memoski and Mr. Memoski were already taken. So, I really hope that if you look at it manually, that you subscribe to the correct one. I don't really want to have those persons, I really want to think that they're nice persons, give them trouble by making people think that they're YouTubers or artists or, well, pseudo-artists. I don't know how to call myself, I just like drawing and doing some jobs here and there. But yeah, I don't want to give them trouble, so just make sure to subscribe to the right Memoski. And yeah, that's good for them and good for me, maybe. So yeah, this night is taking forever. Well, as long as nights are supposed to take. But other than that, one of the deaths, it's not going so bad. Does this snowball cannon actually cause damage? 10 ranged damage, not worth it, because my weapons do far more than that. Let's just take a look at the musket. The musk is a musket. I should be able to rename weapons. I would really like that. Anyhow, see? I'm taking pot shots at them and my accuracy still sucks, but that's on me, not on the game. It's not the bow, it's the user, I don't know, the bowman? Bowman, yeah, why not? Why not? How is the loot doing over here? One gold coin. I have how are 10 lenses, 2 more, and I would be able to fight that thing 2 times in a row. This guy gives me an idea. If I use grenades instead, then I would probably be able to defeat the enemies, well, the boss faster. I don't know. But hey, 100 zombies, not bad. Or even better, if I just put this over here and then I put this over here, then it should be even easier now. I don't know if the villagers get any sort of buff from this, but they're not that hard at this point. I mean, if a zombie kills me, then I will be mad, because, well, what usually kills me is my own incompetence, and being killed by a zombie is not exactly different from that. Zombies, they almost cause no damage. Little to no damage. Let's put that to a test. Where is a zombie? A regular one, please. Why are Hilbert's put shoes on fire? 12 damage from a special kind of zombie. Yes, that's not too bad. How about this one? I shouldn't have killed him if I wanted to see if there was some sort of correlation. Or, I don't know, I don't even know what I'm trying to explore here, because I know that my armor is at least good enough to beat these guys. See? 1 damage. That's nice. I don't expect to receive no damage from killing zombies. From getting hit by zombies, I mean. But, well. Not a big issue here. And the Blood Moon is over because, well, the rain still continues, but the night is no longer red. And the music changed, of course. You know, when music changes in a video game, you know that things are starting to heat up and become more thrilling. Probably a boss fight, probably a raid, I don't know. The music, that's what really makes the experience of Terraria here. I prefer the non-rain version of this. So, now that I'm here at the surface, how about taking the life crystal and hope that goblins don't come attacking soon enough? Okay, now, what to do? I have a lot of gold, I have the lenses. Let's go make the eyes. And on the next episode, if my equipment allows it, I'm going to try to fight this thing 2 times. Yeah, that's more than one. I have sticky bombs, I can make an arena. I can prepare proper weapons to cause as much damage as possible. Yeah, this is going to be amazing. I just need to make the things and don't die in the process. I'm more than ready to do it. You'll be careful now. There's nothing around here. The other thing that I could do is throw sticky bombs all around the place and see if I find something else. But nah, let's not do that. Not yet, at least. Come on. Are you going to hunt me for the rest of my life? Because yours is about to end, sir. Here you go. And you're dead. Good enough. Now, let's just be careful around here. Don't fall. Oof, oof, close enough. Okay, this is going to be tricky. There we go. That works. Now, just keep climbing down like some sort of weird spider of that game Incredipede, I suppose. I should really play that game one day. I like that. The vibe it shows, I don't know. I like the style, something very stylistic. Anyhow, my purpose here was to... What the heck is this? Yellow torches, they are made from topaz. No, I'm not going to use them. What I want to do is to make two of these things and then get the heck out. It still managed to hit me. But, well, it wasn't very strong hit, right? So, now I don't want to look like a bride the whole... during my whole... Well, serious. So I'm going to just leave this be. I think I didn't find the groom. That's not a big problem. I have diamonds, I have this Angel Snowball Cannon, I have a rain hat, let's equip that thing. Yeah. That's the kind of style that Mama likes. Now, Shiver Thorns! Sealed block, let's convert these things into, I don't know. Amber. Ah, that's a rare one. Then, do I have any slash? I have a slash. Let's convert all of this into... I have no clue what I'm obtaining from this. Some nice ores, I suppose. Nothing out of the ordinary. But, well, that works anyhow. Let's just deposit all of this, see if there's anything here that I probably should take with me. The ice mirror, let's just leave this here, probably for eternity, until I figure out if I really want to use it. Any more ores around here? Shadow scales, let's take them for now. The golden ores. Howard the Merchant has arrived to replace our dear Gilbert. May he rest in peace. Or like people that say now, rip in peace. Like it's rest in peace, which is kind of redundant, but, well, I don't know. Maybe there's some other meaning that behind that that I don't know about, but, you know what? I have money. I have this guy who refuses to go up for some reason. So let's just keep buying more of this. And how much money do I still think that I made a profit on the previous endeavor. Let's quick stack. Apparently I have no copper in that piggy bank. And let's just take my gel. Do I have any extra gel around here somewhere, or did I already use everything on... Is this all the gel I have left? This uses only one, I had like 300 I think. Did I leave it somewhere else? Okay, here goes the new pitch for a series. The Musky tries to find in Terraria the chest where he left all of his gel. Yeah, that doesn't sound so good. But, well, I don't know. Maybe it has some sort of niche. A niche about people who like watching videos of people finding gel and sorting items all day long. Well, that's not the kind of experience that I'm going to try to do on this series. Because I want the loot. And I think this was good enough. So for now, that's it. Thanks for watching, and the Musky's out.